a couple different library cards you can get. You can get a regular library card where you come into the branch, you bring your identification with you, like a driver's license, with a current address, and you can get a regular library card that will allow you to check out any of the materials in the building and take them back with you to your house, and give you access to all of the electronic materials that we have. And we have a lot on our website. And you can also get an electronic card. Now, the electronic card you can apply for online. It's good for 5 years. The regular card is good for 2 years before you have to renew it. And you can access anything through our website free. You can't check out materials to take home, but you can get it without coming into the library. We'll mail it to you. And the stuff we have on our website is amazing. We have foreign languages. You can get Rosetta Stone is there. Ancestry is there, free. All of this is free. Everything on the site is free. We have other genealogy resources. We have, e-books, of course. We have lots of e-books. In fact, that was another thing I wanted to mention to you. We have yet a new e-book resource now. We have been using Overdrive, that's a company that we work with, provided us so far with about almost 10,000 e-books. We also have several thousand, 12,000, I think, audiobooks through them. But we now have a new service called Cloud Library. Cloud Library has 120,000 e-books and audiobooks that you can check out and download. Again, this is through our website. The website is tangilibrary.com, and it's available for use anywhere you are in the world. As long as you have internet access, you can download books, audiobooks. You know, I think of it like in the old days, I say old days, not that long ago, you went to the beach and you took along a tote with a bunch of paperbacks. You didn't like one, you threw it aside, got another one out of the tote. Well, imagine having hundreds of thousands or millions of books that you're, you know, through a little device. If you have a Kindle or something like that, you can, you don't like what you're reading, through our website, you can get many, many others, and it's free. Again, you download it for free. I know you can get things off of Amazon, Kindles, and so forth that they provide you with, but you have to pay for those. Just so, you know, your tax dollars are at work here. You've paid to have the library get these things and provide them for you, so those are your tax dollars at work, getting you free stuff. So that's another thing that we have just launched, and I wanted to let you know about that. We also have a common read that's starting up. The common read this year, we try to get everybody in the parish to read the same book. The idea being to encourage people to read, of course, first of all, but also to encourage people to talk about the issues that brought up in the book. It's a novel. This year it's called, the book that we have is Where the Crawdads Sing. I don't know if you've read that book or heard about it. It's a great book, and they're making a movie of it in near New Orleans, I think, or in somewhere down in the bayou. It's set in the marshland of North Carolina. So they're making the movie now. It's very interesting. And we have many, many copies of this book available for you to check out. You can buy copies if you want to from our libraries. We have copies for sale as well, audio copies. And we have totes, like a book group that you want everybody to read. Like, you all wanted to read the book together. We have totes you can check out of 20 copies of it, also with audiobooks, and we have ebook versions as well, so all of you could read it and discuss it. You know, it would be a great opportunity for people to talk, to interact. It's kind of the idea of the common read is to get everybody together to interact and share that sense of reading, and that it's important to read. Let me not forget to say that. Very important to read. It's always important for kids, of course, to develop their lives and to grow into a position where they have opportunities. But we should never stop reading. I'm still reading. I've been reading for as long as I've been able to read. And just want to encourage you to take advantage of your public library. We have six of them in the parish. And everything that we have is available without charge because, again, your tax dollars have already paid for it. So, you know, if you don't have a library card, I would encourage you to get one. Again, doesn't cost you anything. If you want the e-card, you can just go on our website, tangilibrary.com, sign up for it on the website, and we'll mail it to you. And we just want you to come and visit. And if you can't come visit in person, I understand that. Please visit our website, and you'll find a ton of information, a lot of stuff to do. Yes, sir. We have those. Yes, sir. Some of them are MP3s, but most of them are CDs. We still have DVDs. That's kind of falling off, but we still have lots of DVDs you can check out if you'd like to. And, of course, we have printed books. I still read printed books. I read the old paper books. But, you know, we have lots more formats now. The library has changed quite a bit over the years, but I think for the better, and we can serve more people that way. So, yes, sir.
So, if you get an e-card,
yes, sir.
Does that come along with the regular card too?
No, it's a separate card. So, if you choose to get an e-card, you wouldn't be able to check out the physical materials and take them home. But if you get a regular card, you get a regular library card, you have access to everything. But you have to come into the library and show your ID and everything.
So the regular card will let you get into the electronics.
Right. It'll give you access to
everything. And that's free.
Yes, sir. All of it's free. Yes, sir.
Can you get it online, or do you have to come in?
Well, the library card, the regular library card, you have to come in because we have to see. Since you're taking things home, we have to make sure we know where you live and all that.
I had but I guess it was only good for a year or two.
Right. Now they're good for 2 years. You have to renew them after 2 years.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I like that idea of being able to go on Ancestry.
Yeah, right now. Yes, sir. We used to not be able to allow you to do that. The contract we had said you had to be in the library to use Ancestry, but they changed that when COVID came. And so now you can access Ancestry fully from home. And that's a great deal because it would cost you a fair amount of money to join Ancestry. So again, that's another thing you can have access to for free through our libraries.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
I just want to comment about the e-books and stuff. You also have a bunch of paperbacks over there. I know whenever I go on vacation, I may load up a few books. But
yes, sir.
To me, it's easier on the airplane.
You can't use your Wi-Fi on the airplane. Yeah.
That's true. And there's no checkout on those.
Paperbacks, you can just take them and bring them back. And yeah, we have people that drop them off to us all the time, but we don't mind if people take them and, you know, share them around. It's just kind of a service.
A couple of things I wanted to mention. Very recently, we changed our hours. We are expanding our hours across the parish, but for us specifically at the Ponchatoula Library, on Monday and Tuesday, we're now open from 10 to 8 p.m., Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, we're open 10 to 6 p.m. Saturday is 10 to 5, and Sundays we are closed. So if you had gotten accustomed to our 10 to 5:30 hour since COVID, we have changed that a little bit. So if you need to come in the evening, you can do that on Mondays and Tuesdays now. I think last time I came, we talked a little bit about some of our COVID procedures, but I just want to make sure you all know that we are still keeping everything in mind as far as social distancing at our computers, and our staff and patrons are required to wear masks right now. So if you were concerned at all about the safety of coming into our branch, you don't need to worry about that. We're doing our very best to keep things sanitized and then clean and in good order for everyone when you come in. The only thing that we are doing a little bit different is for our programs that I'll be talking to you all about, we do ask that you register. We weren't doing that so much before. We just said, come on over, but because we are trying to do some socially distancing and make sure that everyone has that safe space, we're limiting the amounts of people that can come to things a little bit more. So the way you can register for things are to either go to our website and you click on the calendar. You'll click on the program that you want to go to and it'll give you a way to fill out a form to register. Or you can always give us a call and we'll do it for you over the phone. So you have two options. So let's talk a little bit about what we have going on. We are trying to do as much as we can in the branch still because we know people were for a while missing our programs in person. So we are offering in-person programs now, but we are still offering our virtual programs for those people that are not comfortable coming into the branch yet. So I'm going to tell you a little bit about both for all of the different age groups. So starting in September on Tuesdays, we're going to have Baby and Me at 10:30 a.m. Our teens will meet at 4, and our adventure club will meet at 5. So Baby and Me is a program for adult caregivers and their babies. So they sing songs, play games, do little movement activities, things that are age appropriate for the babies to promote early literacy skills for the child. It's really fun. Michelle, who puts that program together for all of our branches, is just the most personable, wonderful person, and the babies love her. You can also watch Virtual Baby and Me on our Facebook page or on our YouTube page on, every Monday at 11. So you can do both, or you can do one or the other, whatever works for your family. You can get to our Facebook page and our YouTube page by links on our website. So really, you just have to know where to go on our website and you'll find everything that you need. Our Adventure Club is an after-school program for second to fifth graders, and they do things like explore books, they play games, they do a lot of crafts. So it's really fun activities for them to be able to engage in after school. They also have their virtual programs on every Wednesday at 11. Our teen club is where teens can get together with new friends, or their regular friends can go together, and they do a lot of crafting and exploring new ideas and just learning about new things as they're getting into a new age group, you know. So they can come in and do that, or they can watch our teen programming on Thursdays at 11. Now, Wednesdays are going to be our story time day. That's at 10:30, and our story time is for kids ages 3 to 6, and they enjoy stories and action rhymes, and they'll do simpler crafts, dancing, singing, things like that. It's a lot of fun. They also have a virtual version of that that is aired every Tuesday at 11. Thursdays, just once a month, the second Thursday of every month at 1, we're going to have a homeschool book club. So any kids who are homeschooled can get together as a group, and we'll be doing a book club with them. They'll select their books and as a group, and then meet each month to discuss the book and do an activity related to the book they've been reading. And Saturdays, we have bingo for all ages at 1 every Saturday. And so it's a lot of fun. We've been having people come and they really enjoy it. Sometimes we'll do different themed bingos, and but we have been getting all ages, so it's really a lot of fun. We're going to be starting something new, which myself and our new program, our children's programmer, her name is Thora, she is starting up a STEM Saturday, and we're going to do that every third Saturday of the month. And this is primarily going to be for kids ages 7 to 11. But we're, of course, not going to turn anyone away who's outside of that age range. They're going to be doing lots of fun activities, science experiments, and things that explore science, technology, engineering, art, math, all of those great STEM activities. So she's already got a lot of great ideas on what she's going to plan each month with the kids. Now for adults, we haven't forgotten you guys. We have things for adults as well coming up. Our knitting group meets every Monday at 1 p.m. No experience is necessary. So if you want to learn how to knit, all you need to do is bring your own yarn and your own sticks. And the people in the group are always very happy to help show you what to do. They're a fun group of people, and they will often be teaching each other new stitches. So it's a great place to learn and also meet people who are interested in the same thing that you are. We're going to be having Adult Crafternoon every third Friday of the month. And this is gonna be a great time for adults to come and do their own crafting. And myself and a couple other staff members will be leading those activities. And I'm really excited because we have some fun crafts that we've planned. In November, we'll make a paper poinsettia wreath in time for the holidays. And then in December, we're going to make these really cute little mini winter hat ornaments, or you could attach them to presents as a little decoration. So they have a couple of different uses, and they're very cute. We also are bringing back our book club. So we had taken a little bit of a hiatus from being able to do our book club, but we're bringing it back. And there's a list of all the different book selections for the next few months if you're interested. We now have a partnership with the USS Kidd Museum in Baton Rouge. We have a family pass, so it can be two adults and two children, or one adult and three children, can get into the museum as well as the ship for free with this pass. You check it out as if you were checking out a regular library book, and then you return it. Yes. And so it's a great way to enjoy that without having to pay those entry fees. So if you're interested in doing that, you can stop by and check that pass out.
We canceled it last year. This year we're bringing it back. And we are just over the moon happy to be bringing the air show back.
Dates are October 16th and 17th. We want to thank all of our sponsors. First County Bank is our presenting sponsor. We also want to thank the City of Hammond and all their wonderful crews, the police department, the fire department, and all the work they do to make this show a success, and Tangipahoa Parish Government for their assistance in every step of the way.